Live from New York City, it's theCUBE. Now, here is your host, Dave Vellante.
Hi everybody, this is Dave Vellante and you're watching theCUBE. We are on the ground at the USS Intrepid at the MapR Party. Jabari Norton is here, he runs strategic alliances for MapR. Jabari, thanks for coming on.
Absolutely, thanks Dave, appreciate
so,
it.
So what's happening? Where are we in the state of big data? What's happening? Everybody's out doing deals, making alliances, you've been busy.
We've been really busy here. You know, we've got a lot going on with Cisco Systems. That's part of one of the partners that we have here tonight. But lots of different partners actually in the ecosystem. It's very funny. I've been at MapR now for 3 years, and it's amazing to kind of see what the amount of traction that we've got. We're still early innings with where we got, but we've got a long way to go.
So I got to ask you. So everybody's doing deals. Everybody's inking contracts, press releases. How do you differentiate? How do we as observers differentiate what we sometimes call the Barney deals? You know what I mean? The deals that don't really have a lot of teeth from those ones that actually produce value for customers and obviously for the suppliers as well. How do you do that? How do you choose and pick?
Well, really, you're looking for business outcomes, right? That's what you're really looking for. Is you have lots of deals that are in early stages, people kicking the tires, et cetera. You want to find those deals that actually are delivering results to the end users that are delivering business outcomes. With Hadoop, you can download it and kind of figure it out from there. But what we really try and do is to try and go in and find those deals where it's going to make an impact to the customer, even driving top line revenue or reducing costs. And that's really where MapR has a differentiated solution and drives those production-based applications.
So talk a little bit about that differentiation, right? Because you got tons of action, a lot of competition. How do you position MapR? How do you differentiate? What are your strengths relative to others? And specifically, what do you emphasize when you're doing partnerships?
Well, it really comes down to three big things. And we've been preaching this for 3 years and the 6 years that MapR has been around. Is one is we make Hadoop easy, right? Easier to use, easier to integrate with those applications too. Much more dependable. So enterprise grade, high availability, what you would expect from an enterprise class solution, and performance and fast. So delivering much faster, greater TCO to customers, and that performance you would expect from a world-class enterprise Hadoop distribution.
So we talk to a lot of practitioners and they tell us, Hadoop's hard, right? The guys at the left side of the bell curve are doing a great job. They got the skill sets, they got the data scientists, but the fat middle, they're really struggling, they got a hard time. Talk a little bit more about how you simplify Hadoop, how you make it easier, maybe even some examples of partnerships that you bring to the table to make things easier.
So really what we do is we bring Hadoop to the masses and what we do there. Our partnerships that we have with Cisco, where you're actually bringing a full integrated stack there, where you're bringing in third-party solutions, whether it be an Informatica, SaaS, et cetera, charity, bring them all together so customers can have a full stack solution and can deliver true business outcomes. While Hadoop is the platform, you really need those applications that sit up on the top layer above that to bring it all together for the customer. So that ecosystem and those partners that we're really building are driving tremendous value to our customers.
So we get this question a lot from our practitioners in the Wikibon community. They say, is my data warehouse a dinosaur? What should we tell them?
I wouldn't say it's a dinosaur, but it's something that you actually have. So what you need to do is really analyze what's in that. What are the right data types to be sitting in that data warehouse? If there's newer data types, unstructured data types that aren't really designed for that data warehouse, put those in Hadoop. Those data sets, those structured data sets, some of those data sets that are designed for the data warehouse, keep those there and you can kind of have a tiered-based data platform where you can run some of your apps in the data warehouse as well as some of your apps in Hadoop.
Okay, so you see the data warehouse, the traditional data warehouse is a fundamental part of a customer's big data strategy, is that right?
Yeah, nobody's throwing anything out in the data center, right? They've made way too much investment, there's way too many applications that are there. You have to kind of co-mingle with actually what's there and really kind of take the best of all the different technologies and drive that business value that's actually there. Hadoop brings that commodity level clustered-based distribution of storing tons of data from an unstructured standpoint and bringing that to the masses.
So from a tooling standpoint, I got to believe data integration is like top of the list. You mentioned Informatica. SyncSort is one of your sponsors here. Attunity is another company, you know,
Talent
working on
well.
That. Talent as well. I mean, that seems to me to be critical. Do customers understand that? Do they, I mean, you see a lot of big data projects spinning up. Mm-hmm. Is anybody paying attention to data quality, data governance, data integration from a strategic perspective? Or is it more just sort of bespoke projects that ultimately somebody's going to have to clean up? What do you think about that?
So it goes back to your fourth point, right? Where MapR plays is really is more those production grade distributions, right? When you're kind of going into production and you're really looking at those enterprise grade qualities, that's when those third party ecosystem projects are really important, right? When you're in the early stages and you're just kicking the tires, nobody really thinks about those things. When you're putting them in production, those other solutions really matter, and that's where our partners really come into play, and that's where MapR delivers a tremendous amount of value.
If you talk to a lot of customers, obviously US MapR company, and you personally with some of your partners. Where do you think we are? If you had to take a sort of random sample of customers, what percent do you think are actually in production with a Hadoop? And this is it's a little biased because you guys probably have more as a percentage in production, but what do you think as a sampling across, let's take North America, as a sampling across North America, what percent of the customers would you say have Hadoop in production today?
I would say it's probably in the 5 or 10% range. If you kind of look at Gartner and what Forrester say, it's in the 5 to 10% range. When you look at MapR customers, we're in the 70 to 80% range. Really, we give those enterprise gear capabilities. We make it much easier to use. So if you're a large enterprise looking to deploy this, we provide to you those enterprise class features that are there day one and the ability to do that. So we're still early in that production adoption curve, but it's moving extremely fast in that direction.
So you think, you like to talk in funnels, right? Any salesperson wants to talk in funnels. So the top of the funnel is guys that are, thinking about big data, that, Hadoop is going to be, they're considering it as part of their data strategy, which is kind of everybody.
Absolutely.
And that's a big chunk of the world. And then you got the guys that are sort of kicking the tires, doing some science experiments, and then you got the guys in production. How does MapR sort of work that funnel with this partnership to make sure that they're coming into your world and not going to your competitors?
Well, what's interesting is I think of it like an hourglass. So we have the funnel on the top where they're kind of coming down and coming in, going from kicking the tires into production. We actually see an hourglass effect in the bottom end. Once we get those first production use cases in, they expand rapidly. We're seeing 3x, 5x, 10x production increases of use cases and cluster sizes actually after they put those first use cases in. So we really see that kind of concave effect. So they come in the top, they kind of get narrow, and they really expand out once they get in the production.
So that's interesting. So we were talking about the enterprise data warehouse before, but would you agree that the enterprise data warehouse spending patterns are shifting? That people are maybe rethinking where they're going to put their investments. They're maybe putting some R&D money or maybe more production money into Hadoop and maybe baselining their enterprise data warehouse. I agree with you. It's a fundamental part of their strategy, but it's not sucking up the budget, right? Would you agree with that?
I would definitely agree with that.
So where do you think that goes over time? Is the Hadoop tail going to eventually become the dog?
I think it will, right? I mean, I think it's going to take some time, right? It's not going to be something you do overnight. But I think as customers start to see really the value, the production grade quality that you can get out of distributions like MapR, et cetera, you're going to see that tail starting to wag the dog in the near future.
Jabari, I love your enthusiasm. You guys got some momentum. Thanks very much for coming on theCUBE. It was a pleasure.
Absolutely. Thanks.
All right, this is Dave Vellante, and you're watching theCUBE.